We are at Gautam's graduation. December 12, 1998.
I'm going
straight down South. Yeah,
this
is your first visit.
I'll take it. Well, then we'll
just
push you all the way down.
Okay. Can you say hi? Gautam's up there somewhere. By paid on. Gautam!
If you want to take pictures, you may want to wait till the ceremony is over because someone would be on the platform to get that picture of your loved one who will be getting the degree today. We need to keep the lanes open, though, as you do your photography, so that the students can go back and forth to their seats without difficulty. And it's very important to stay until the end of the ceremony so that the students and the platform party and the faculty may recess from the building at our concession in this morning. Dr. Lois Whitby and Dr. Ivan Palmer. Dr. Whitby, would you stand, please? Dr. Whitby has devoted essentially a professional life. You're the star of the show today, and thousands of people have gathered here to celebrate your accomplishments. How often will that happen in your lifetime? Savor the day. It's a good one. You have been part of a major transformation in higher education. Since you started school, three trends have changed the face of teaching and learning: the knowledge explosion, instructional technology, and adult learning. First of all, the knowledge explosion. If you laid on a table before you every book you read, every paper you wrote, every exam you passed, and every notebook you filled while you were in college, you would be astounded at what you have accomplished. And if you had seen that heap of work before you started, you would have thrown your hands up and said, "It's impossible. I can never do all that." Yet here you are, having mastered all of it. Take time to feel the relief that comes from the completion of very intense work. But you can't stop there. What you have learned is only a tiny fragment of what there is to know. An unprecedented knowledge explosion has swept the planet. More information is produced in a single day than you could possibly read in an entire lifetime. Each year, 600,000 books are newly published, adding to the millions already in print. Since you entered Frost Arena, 70 new books have been published. And before you leave, 140 more new books will be added to the list. You couldn't possibly read them all in a whole lifetime. Harvard University subscribes to 160,000 journals, publishing millions of articles each year. If you read two newly published articles every night, by the end of the year, you'd be 800 years behind in your reading. Compounding the knowledge explosion is the proliferation of internet sites. America Online users set an all-time record in October as 10 million online hours were logged in one 24-hour period.
The Regents of Higher Education, State of South Dakota, have authorized South Dakota State University to offer graduate study leading to the Doctor of Philosophy degree. Dr. David Hildebrand, Dean of the Graduate School, will present the candidates for the doctoral degree. Dean Hildebrand.
Gautam Sarkar, whose major advisor is Dr. John Fitzgerald. Mr. Paydon Zhao, whose major advisor is Dr. Jay Shore, in order that you may confer upon them the degree of Doctor of Philosophy.
by virtue of the authority delegated to me by the Regents of Higher Education of the State of South Dakota, I confer upon your candidates the degree Doctor of Philosophy with all the rights, privileges, and responsibilities pertaining thereto. The candidates will now proceed to the stage accompanied by their major professors. The candidates will receive their doctoral hoods from Dr. Hildebrand and their major advisor, and then the advisor and I will introduce each of the newly awarded recipients to the audience.
President Elliott, I am pleased to introduce to you and those assembled Dr. Julia Strather Keep, whose field of study was chemistry.
President Elliott, I'm pleased to introduce to you and those present Dr. Gautam Sarkar, whose field of study was chemistry.
Officially graduates of South Dakota State University, and I will